Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm on another hair dye adventure. I'm gonna be trying out this time the Colour Freedom Metallic Glory Denim Permanent Hair Colour in Stone Wash, and that's what it looks like. It's kind of like a grey blue colour. I guess it's supposed to be kind of like after like denim jeans. And I thought it looked like a pretty cool colour, so I'm gonna give this a go. Previously I did use the L'Oreal Colorista hashtag grey hair. I have a video on that if you're interested. This did not work very well for me. Obviously my hair is not like really a clean blonde, and this does like recommend that you have like a proper clean blonde hair and with no like brassiness to it when you use it, but my hair does have some brassiness to it, but I'm gonna use it anyway. But obviously I can't expect it to look perfect because of that, but it'll do something. I just don't know exactly what it's going to do, but we'll find out in this video. So I've separated my hair into three sections and I've just got to put the mix together and then we can just get on with it. Okay, so we have the cream developer here and you just take the lid off, and then from what I've gathered from the instructions, you just put all of the colourant into that, shake it up and apply everywhere. It's just pretty much your average hair dye. I was just squirting it into the bottle without actually piercing the lid. Oops. Got it all mixed. Hopefully I've mixed properly. My arms hurt, so that's all I'm going to be asked to do. So I'm just going to go ahead, put my gloves on. I'm going to apply this all in my hair, hope for the best. I do have another box, so if there is not enough product in this to cover my whole hair, I will mix up another one. But we will just go ahead. Oh my god, this is so weird. I don't know if I've just done something wrong, but like the dye, it squirts out from all four sides rather than coming out the top. Like, is that how it's supposed to happen? Weird. Anyway, it's like, I can't even explain it. Like, when I squirt it, it comes out. Can you see that? That's just so odd. I'm gonna have to make another batch, I think, because I can't get anything more out of this weirdly designed bottle. So we've got another batch. Right, let's finish off. Took me absolutely ages to apply because I had to actually cut into the bottles. Just because I could just tell that there was product in there that just didn't want to come out. And I was right, because when I opened it there was quite a lot of product left, but I cut into both of them and I've used it all. And my hair looks quite dark. So God knows how this is going to turn out, but I guess we'll see. I believe it's 25 minutes I have to wait. So I'll wait for 25 minutes, I'll wash it off, and we'll see what we've got to work with. So it's been about 5 days since I washed it off. I know I should have filmed this like the next day or like straight afterwards, but I could give you a million excuses as to why I didn't, but I've not actually done anything to my hair since then. I've not washed it, which I know is a bit gross, but I don't like to wash my hair too much. So the colour that it was when it washed off is pretty much the same as it is now. Some of my spring makeup videos are going to go up in the next few days. You can kind of see it like as like the day after I washed it off. I think number 3 was the day after I washed it off, so it looked pretty good in that. So as you can tell, it didn't really like go the colour of the box. If you look at the kind of like my roots, it has actually kind of gone that colour, that kind of like blue toned grey. It has actually picked up quite a bit, not perfectly, on my kind of more lighter bits of my hair. So that's quite cool. But as you can see, like the rest of my hair didn't really pick up on the grey. But I actually do like what it has done to my hair, because what it's done is my hair was quite yellow before, and this has actually kind of like neutralised that a bit and kind of took away some of that brassiness, which I actually really like. Obviously, it's not what I expected to happen, but I'm not complaining, because I mean, I did kind of need to neutralise that brass in my hair anyway. So I'm just thinking, if you have really yellow toned, like blonde, bleached blonde hair, and you're struggling to get a toner to work for you, maybe try a silver or a grey hair dye, and that might actually help to neutralise your hair. You can kind of see like a slight grey tint to the kind of the other bits of my hair. There is a slight grey tint there. It's obviously not consistent, but like it's definitely there. So I'd say that the dye, it did work kind of in bits of my hair, as you can see like here. It did kind of get that bluey toned grey look. So I think if you're just starting with a really clean blonde hair, this dye probably would work. But if you had quite yellow toned blonde hair, it's probably not going to come out that colour. But what it will do is it will help to kind of neutralise some of those more intense tones in your hair, which I actually think is pretty cool. Obviously that's not what it's like advertised as or what it's meant to be. So I guess you could say that that makes the product bad, but in a way, I like the effect of it. Like, I actually like how my hair looks now, even though it's not what I expected from the dye. I hope I'm making sense here, but, so if you had a similar type of hair to what I had before, this is probably what you can expect to get from it. You will have a slight grey tone, but it's not going to be anything really opaque. But, I think it's worth trying, just because it has made my, like, hair a much more kind of, like, almost like a goldeny blonde or like dirty blonde, and I actually quite like it. So I actually like the finished result, even though it's not what it's like advertised as. But so my opinion is I like the dye, even though it's not exactly what it says it is, if that makes sense. But I'm definitely still going to try some different things on my hair. I do kind of want to get a kind of more grey hair, so I'm probably going to try some more grey dyes. If anyone's got any like recommendations of grey dyes that they think will work on my type of hair, where it's not like white blonde but it is quite light, let me know, because I will appreciate that if you can get me a dye that like will make my hair really grey. I mean, look at it. I mean, like, I do like the colour that it is like in my kind of lighter bits, so I wouldn't mind if my hair was like that all over, but I don't know if it's even possible to get a grey dye that's going to work on this blonde, or if I just need to get my hair lighter before I can even do that. Who knows? But anyway, so I hope you got some insight into how this dye is going to work on hair that's my type. Obviously, it's going to work completely different on people's hair, depending on what their original colour was. I do think if you had a very light blonde, that you probably would get a better result, and you would get that more kind of grey, bluey toned colour that I've got in my kind of roots areas. Definitely would work. So thank you for watching this video. I hope it was somewhat helpful. And I will see you in my next one. Goodbye.